Hi Virgo, this is Kelly from House of Virgo. Welcome to my channel. If you are new, please do hit the subscribe button. This is going to be your next 24 hours love reading for all Virgos, Virgo Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus. We're going to do past, present, future. All the links you need to book a personal reading, follow me on Instagram, everything is below this reading. All right, let's get right into it. Oh, Virgo. Okay. Past position, King of Cups. And the Death card. Ten of Wands. Current. Three of Cups. The Four of Cups. And the Ace of Wands. And the Future. Four of Swords. The Eight of Swords. And the Eight of Wands. All right, Virgo. You know what, I'm gonna add some overall energy here. The Ace of Pentacles, almost said the Ace of Cups, the Ace of Pentacles at the bottom of the reading here. Something new, a new opportunity coming to you in your life. This could be a new job, could be getting a raise or promotion, could be a new income or an investment opportunity. As far as love goes, something real, a gift coming to you within the next, you know, either the next 24 hours or going forward, okay? So let's leave that energy there and take a look at the past energy, whom you may have been connecting with, or a situation. King of Cups, so on the board we have Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, possible a younger fire sign, okay? So King of Cups is here in your past. Now, doesn't have to be that sign. King of Cups is usually someone who's very supportive, tolerant, empathetic, does not wear his emotions on his sleeve. He's quite guarded with his emotions, okay? But he can be very nurturing, healing, and supportive, male or female, okay? Feels things very deeply. Cups are all about the emotions and the love. And this person, their decisions that they make when it comes to relationships are not logical. They're usually about the emotions, okay? The King of Cups is very wise and knows how he feels, he or she. But in the masculine form, this king sometimes may create waves or has perhaps created some waves in the past, but always remains steady. I feel like you may have felt like the waves crashing up upon the rock of this person, perhaps trying to get in or connect on an emotional level, but this king sits on a solid concrete slab and chair, very rock solid. And tremendously, like, with, I feel like a blockage, has like a blockage, very difficult to penetrate. Death is here. So there's some type of transformation and ending that has happened in the past with this person. Okay. Could be any sign. Just remember that whatever your person's sign is, they're reflecting as the King of Cups, as being representing the emotions. And the Ten of Wands is here. Stress, exhaustion, too many burdens. This person may have ended something with you because it was too exhausting or too stressful. I feel like perhaps they tried to make a transition or try to have something new with you in the past, but I feel like they came to this decision that it was just too much to bear, too much of a burden, and perhaps in the past they walked away. All right, but let's get some clarity on the King of Cups. Show me this King of Cups, please. Okay, the Two of Pentacles. This person couldn't make a decision. Weighing, just was constantly, maybe they were juggling something, okay? Lost in their finances, trying to balance things. I mean, it was kind of also like, should I feel like, you see how he's got these pentacles up and down? It was kind of like, should I commit or should I not? Usually when the Two of Pentacles is in the reverse, this represents someone who has an inability to commit. I feel like this person has an ability or had an ability to commit, but they were kind of like not sure about it, not sure if they could make it work or balance it. I feel like this person felt like it would be too much for them to handle. Let's take a look at the Death card. Why is the Death card here? Because that can be a card about endings. Okay. Yeah. The Lovers. They made a decision to walk away from your connection in the past. They chose. They wanted love. So I feel like it's two storylines with this person. It feels like they were kind of like, the Two of Pentacles, the upright, is an ability to commit, but maybe they had so much going on in their life, juggling so many things, physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually, that they had to pull away, okay? But at the same time, they wanted to be with you, even though there were some burdens or obstacles, is how I feel. But I also feel like this person may have put these obstacles in front of themselves, like they picked up a lot of extra stuff to block it in a lot of ways because they weren't sure that they would be able to go forward. So perhaps they came up with these, you could call them excuses, you could call them reasons, whatever it might be. You know, this guy, he picked up those wands, those sticks, right? He could have only had to, you know, he could have just picked up two or three, but he chose to pick them all up as if, oh, I can't, I've got all this going on and I'm too busy, or I have these heavy burdens, or I'm exhausted or stressed. It might have been something that they told you. But I do feel like they were trying to balance things in their life. Let's take a look here. Ten of Wands. Yep, Nine of Cups, see? This person was of two minds. I feel like they did love you. And, you know, they wanted to propose. They wanted to, you know, be romantic, you know, offer their love. This is Prince or Prince Charming. It could have been financial reasons. It could have been that they had a child that they were trying to take care of. If they were a single parent. I just want to pull a clarifying card, one more for the Lovers. Because I feel like this person saw that this was a twin flame connection, whether they knew what that meant or not, but they chose to end it. Yeah, see, the Three of Swords. And the bad, not the bad, but the worst thing about it is like when death comes, sometimes there is no opportunity to say goodbye. And I feel like this person, that's what happened. They may have just ended the relationship. The relationship died and then they became this ghost and ghosted you. Okay. So this person also had a fear of heartbreak, or there was some type of third party thing that came out and they walked away. Okay, and yet it just feels like they loved you. There was just way too much of a struggle for them to offer commitment or marriage or just give you their full cup of love. Okay, and that's the past and that's kind of sad. But I feel like this is a general reading and maybe it's not for all of you, but that's the energy that I'm picking up. This person may have also been... This person, I feel like, may have also felt maybe you had a third party or and walked away, or they felt as if they would get their heart broken if they came into union with you. Okay. I don't know, there's a fear. It just feels more like they would rather have walked away than get their heart open, their heart and be vulnerable. You know, the lovers is about vulnerability, being with no shame and telling the other person, like, you're coming in and your full nakedness and everything. This person felt like a thing about that, like they didn't want to fully reveal themselves to you, but they loved you, and they knew that to be in union with you was going to require that. Okay, so currently this person is speaking to others, okay, males or females. This is a card of like celebration, friendship, circle of support. It can be dating. It can also be partying, but not too much. It could just be keeping things very light and fun and nothing serious. This is like happy hour and then for a certain amount of time and then going home. But you know what? They have their communications with others. And then they've got the Four of Cups, where they're truly not fulfilled with these three cups here. You see this? There's three cups here. They're not fulfilled. That doesn't do anything for them. They're quite indifferent to it. So if they're talking to other people, it's nothing compared to you and the love that you have offered. Look at that cup there in the air. That cup's huge. The big love offer, the Ace of Cups. And yet, this person just sits in this position of like down on themselves. They're not sure if they can offer you the love that you're offering to them. When love comes in, they maybe just try to keep it, they're keeping it kind of surface right now. This person rejects you or is rejecting you right now in order to self-protect, so they don't have to look at themselves. Okay. But there is some kind of like surprise gift coming in for them. Maybe something from you. Maybe currently you will be offering your love in some way. And the Ace of Wands is here. And that feels like a spark. So if you're thinking about reaching out to this person, or you're thinking about expressing your love or proposal or romantic, you know, type of thing, or a relationship or something to them, I feel like there's going to be a spark, a there's an inspiration, reigniting a spark here, and feeling an urge to have a new beginning, like a passionate draw. But let's get some clarifiers here. The Three of Cups. Let's look at the Three of Cups. Okay, yeah. See the Page of Cups. This person's really just flirting. They are trying to keep their mind off of their deep emotions or their feelings, or some heartbreaking feelings of something that might have happened in the past. Currently, they're chit-chatting with others, you know, they're being flirtatious. It could be talking to, you know, people at work. They're volunteering themselves, like they're purposely reaching out to others. Maybe try to make themselves feel better, or just keep it light and airy so that they're not alone, but it's really not helping them too much here with the Four of Cups. They don't want anybody else's true cup of love. They want, you know, they see that yours was the biggest and the best, you know, it touched them in a way, you know, but they're also not, it feels like apathetic to having a new start in love, right? Their emotions, not so much, you know, that's tough for this person, but for the physical passion, that's, they're all, they got that. Let's take a look at the Four of Cups. Okay, Six of Cups here. They are still thinking about you, Virgo. you're on their mind all the time. They're not, I feel like they're kind of like trapped in their thoughts about the past. They think about reunion with you, or, you know, they think about the innocence, and there's nostalgia to this card. And again, this is gifts. If you reach out to them or send them some kind of a gift of some sort, like something sweet, I do feel like there is going to be a desire emotionally, like you're going to trigger something within them, past memories. When you were younger, you know, it doesn't, I mean, or when you met, okay, this could be somebody from your childhood that you've known, or you knew when you guys, you know, maybe there's children, maybe you have children together, thinking about the children. So let's take a look at the Ace of Wands, children or a child, or thinking about a time when things were good and sweet and innocent. Okay, Ace of Wands, please. Okay, oh wow, I'm telling you, there's gonna be like a transition. I feel like, I'm not telling you to reach out to this person, Virgo, but I do feel like if you were to, it would spark something in them to actually overcome their fears and get out of some kind of stagnant energy that they've been in, or this emotional turmoil, because I feel like your person is in deep emotional turmoil, but they're not sharing it with you. And the Six of Swords is, it's kind of like a necessary transition. Like they know in order to, this spark encourages, influences this change coming forward in this person. It could be relocation or travel. You know, it's movement here. There's a spark. I don't know what you know, it doesn't have to be an actual gift. It could just be something heartwarming. And I feel like there's, you know, movement forward. Okay, they didn't want to give me anything else. Let's go into the future and see what the energy is here. So the Four of Swords. It's peace. These two energies, the Eight of Swords and the Four of Swords, are very conflicting. I feel like, you know, you might be dealing with someone that has something going on with them where they have really deep insecurities. They have mental conflict, but then at other times they rest and they're okay and they're calm. I feel like this is turmoil, this person. And this just feels like their energy. This may be something that you know about with them, and I don't feel like this is, I feel like this is how they are all the time, no matter what. And I do see like an element of, I just heard a desire to change something here. Let me see. Let me get a clarifying card, because the Four of Swords energy is like being able to rest and having a renewal going forward. So there is some kind of like retreat. What is this Four of Swords? Okay, the Moon. Oh yeah, dreams. You know what? That's what it is. This person has these, all of their emotions and feelings in regard to going forward is going to start surfacing very slowly in their dreams, having these deep emotional dreams about you when they're sleeping. This person dreams about you. And it's not like they lay down and they just choose to dream about you. Like you are in their subconscious. And that's what that moon energy is. Like the only way they can really understand how they feel is in their dreams. One more card for the moon. So we have Gemini here on the table. We also have Pisces, Cancer. Okay. The Eight of Pentacles. I just heard they try very hard not to forget you. Even when they're working, or whatever it is that they're doing or trying to accomplish in their day to day. They dream also about what life would be like for the two of you if effort was really put in to express the feelings and the emotions. They think about this. You know, maybe you've done that, but I feel like going forward, things are coming up into their mind. They wake up in the morning and they remember a dream that they had about you. And then it's almost like, and then in their day, but they remember it, or it's not when they wake up in the morning. It's like they'll be doing something in their day to day or in work. And then maybe just working or what have you going forward. And then all of a sudden they remember a dream that they had about you, and it triggers something within them. And then the Eight of Swords is here where they feel helpless. I just heard that song, Dreaming of You by Selena, the High Priestess. Then they're very passionate about you, Virgo, but their emotions trap them. They get their head messed up and then they don't communicate going forward. They're not communicating with you. Like so the secrets that they hold on to is that they have a deep insecurity about themselves. They feel restricted to speak, to express, or to tell you about these deep, you know, they feel imprisoned in their mind. They stay quiet and they don't share. And that's their energy going forward, you know? It's a real struggle for this person, but I feel like they do love you. And here's the Knight of Wands. And you know, their mental and their emotional stuff is really difficult for them to deal with. But the physical activity, they're fine with that. Like, they can do that. And maybe how they find ways to express their emotions and their thoughts is through their physical activity. Now, the Knight of Wands can be very lusty and free-spirited. They may express themselves through creative endeavors. But I do feel like they are going to be, you know, inspired by something that you send them, but I don't feel like it's going to be the cornucopia of full expression of emotions going forward. I feel like it's going to be this energy, which seems like that's the best way they know how to express. So I'm not seeing like an overnight change here with this person, and I feel like if there's a comeback around with them, for you to lower your expectations as much as you can. You don't have to accept anything you don't wish for, but yeah, that's where they gain their courage and their strength through. They may mask emotional intimacy with sexual encounters with you. That's how they connect. Okay, that's Leo energy. We have another Virgo there. Let's see what else. Another card for strength. I want to just wait. Let me look at strength and then I'm going to clarify the High Priestess. Yep, that's totally what I was saying. They mask their emotions with physical, lusty connection with you. Okay? So if you're wondering, well, are they just wanting you for SEX or for sex? That too, but it's not only that's their way of expressing their love, by touching, hugging, kissing, the physical act. Now you may say, well, that's not going to work for me, and that's fine. And but you may say, okay, I get it, and maybe there's something we can do here to try to help them open up more. But that's entirely up to you if that's something that you want to heal with this person. Let's take a look at the High Priestess. This person keeps a lot of deep secrets. They don't like to expose themselves. They keep themselves restricted and blocked. They keep themselves, it's like self-protection. Like, they could get out of this if they want to, but show me the High Priestess. Okay, Three of Wands. It's like this person is waiting for a rescue. And that's what I feel like. The only way for this person to really open up is for somebody else to, like, rescue. You know, I don't know if you've ever listened to my readings on my other channel, but I used to always feel like this was a damsel in distress. You see, if she was laying flat on the train tracks, you know, male or female. And they stay in that energy, and they don't say anything. They won't admit it, but if you or somebody were to come to them, you know, like waiting there for the ships to see them, if you were to come to them and say, I'm here, I'm open up, things like that. And I mean, I'm not trying to do the whole, I'm not endorsing codependent type of behavior, but I am just giving the message as how I feel this person feels, that they're more inclined to wait for an invitation to open up than they are to just do it on their own. They won't just do it on their own. They need that invitation. So I see them kind of standing there waiting for the invitation, and of course, they will answer it and come towards you. With their cup of love masked in the form of physical pleasure. They wish to be tamed by you, male or female, in some way. All right, let's get a couple. I want to pull some love messages to see how this person feels about you. Because, like I said, I mean, the feelings are kind of missing. They're deeply hidden. And I feel like with you in the present, if you're still communicating with this person, or for some of you, there could be communication with them, but them keeping it light. There could also be an apology, but them kind of keeping it light and sweet, nothing serious. Let's see what their hidden messages are. Okay. I feel you leaving me behind. So, Virgo, maybe you've decided that you're just moving on, and they can feel that. They wish they had treated you better. I feel like they weren't trying to intentionally hurt you. I just feel like they were hurt. Or they were hurting themselves, and in turn you got hurt. Just being near you is intoxicating. They do have that very strong physical attraction to you, Virgo, still. And I am becoming a better person. That's hopeful, because I feel like this person is trying. It was my fault, but I blamed you, Virgo. This person, I feel like they didn't want to take a look at themselves, so they blame shifted. Maybe they blamed you, or they didn't want to accept blame because they already felt bad about themselves. This person wants to be more than friends. I want to be more than friends. I'm so attracted to you. Okay. I love you unconditionally. They must be making some changes in their life here. Something, there's a spark. I want you. There's definitely a passionate spark. The attraction and the physical passion seems to be, you know, the spark. It gives them the urge to want to be with you. Something about you, Virgo, that they're just wild by. The timing just wasn't right for us, okay? That had a lot to do with why this connection really just didn't come to fruition. So many things remind me of you. I feel like other people that they're talking to or have talked to in the past, currently are talking to, that might cause them to feel a bit sad because they can't not, you're in their subconscious, you're in their dreams. They talk to other people and then they're just constant, another woman or male will say something and then they're like reminded of you. I am afraid to contact you. Okay, yeah, there's some insecurity. Like I said, this person is waiting for you to contact them, to reach out to them, to initiate to them, to let them know that it's okay to open up and to share with you. Now, again, if that's something you want to do, go for it. If you're just like, nope, you can't bring yourself to do that for whatever reason, then, you know, you have free will. So you have to do what's best for you at the end of the day, Virgo. Let's take a look here and see what your angel wisdom messages are. Okay, Queen of Cups, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces energy. Loving, compassionate, psychic, self-sacrificing, deep psychic insights, caring for others, but forgetting to take care of yourself. Trust your intuition, Virgo. A deep love of family and friends is important to you, and follow your heart, Virgo. Follow only your heart. Do not listen to anything else but how you feel, your true, good, nurturing, loving feelings. What else? Okay, now you have the King of Pentacles. Compassionate, accomplished, charismatic, grounded, a time of great success, financial security and prosperity, the Midas touch, everything turning out beautifully, a supportive parent and spouse, a good person to work for. Now, this could also be you, Virgo. All right, maybe you are embodying water and the pentacle here, where it's the physical and the emotional. These two things you are trying to connect here. Could also be your person in either one of these. But if it's male, female, you know, there's definitely a match. And it's really not even male, female. It's just masculine and feminine energy. There's a match here. One person is very practical, grounded, very like wise and solid, and the other is quite emotional and deep. Okay. More so. One runs by the heart, and the other one runs by what's real and tangible. Okay, and we have the Eight of Pentacles again. Learning all you can about a subject or career, going back to school, taking a seminar, or finding a mentor. Attention to detail and skilled work that you love. This feels like, you know, finding a mentor is like someone to help you through some personal issues in your life. Maybe you've already got that. Or maybe you're currently seeking out mentorship, a life coach, spiritual counselor, a guru, whichever it might be. It's like working on taking your skills and improving. It could be going back to school, learning some new things, very focused on your work at this time, which might just be a message for you to like do that right now. Stop, get your head out of the clouds and look down and see what's in front of you and focus on, get busy at this time. What else do you have? Oh, you guys, I'm laughing. I swear, I'm going to just change my channel to the Virgo and Emperor channel. The Emperor, again. Logic and organization will increase your success. Take charge of the situation. Accept a leadership role, structure, and discipline. Now, this could be your person. That's Aries energy. But it could very well be a message to you that if there's something here that you feel you want to salvage with somebody, you have to take a leadership role because this person is not going to do it. They will be inspired and they have strong physical urges, but they're afraid to contact you. If you want it, you're going to have to make the first move. If you don't want it, then just make the first move in your life and take control and the power back in your own life and be done with, you know, the Emperor doesn't sit on the fence. He never sits on the fence. He sits on that solid throne, okay? And, you know, even the Empress is the same way. He's like, okay, I'm either in or I'm out. And that's a decision you may need to make. Okay, Virgo. So this is your reading for the next 24 hours. I hope that you enjoy this. I will see you tomorrow. Make sure, please, do hit like, share, and subscribe. All right, Virgo, take care.